Assalamu alaikum. Welcome everyone. In a series of three videos, we'll discuss cellular respiration, which is the process that our bodies use to produce energy in the form of ATP in three main stages. In this video, we'll be talking about the first stage of cellular respiration, glycolysis. Before we begin, we need to understand the two types of metabolism, anabolism and catabolism. Anabolism is the type that uses energy to construct components of cells like proteins and nucleic acids, while catabolism is the type that breaks down organic matter and usually harvests energy, for example, cellular respiration. So, what happens in glycolysis? Our cells break down sugar, known as glucose, which is a 6-carbon molecule, into a 3-carbon energy-rich molecule that is called pyruvate or pyruvic acid. This process happens every day in all of our cells' cytoplasm, while the other two stages of cellular respiration, as we'll see in future videos, take place in the cell's mitochondria. So, cells without mitochondria, such as red blood cells, rely solely on glycolysis to produce energy. Glycolysis can be aerobic, requiring oxygen to follow up with the next stages of cellular respiration, or anaerobic, occurring without the participation of oxygen. Anaerobic glycolysis happens in cells that lack mitochondria and in oxygen-deprived cells. In order for glycolysis to occur, we need to allow the glucose molecule to enter the cell. This is done by two systems, which are the sodium-dependent co-transporter system, CGLT, and the protein transporter system, GLUT, or GLUT. Sodium-dependent cotransporters require energy in order to move glucose from the outside of the cell, where there is lower concentration, to the inside of the cell, where there is higher concentration. In this case, energy is supplied in the form of sodium's concentration gradient. This system is mainly used in the renal tubules and in the intestinal epithelium. While the protein transporter system uses facilitated diffusion to carry the glucose molecule to the inside of the cell, this system is made up of a family of 14 glucose transporters, designated GLUT1 to GLUT14, which are found in the cell membranes. Out of these 14 transporters, GLUT4, which is abundant in skeletal muscle and adipose tissue, requires insulin in order to uptake glucose from the blood. Now that the glucose molecule is inside the cell, glycolysis can occur in the cytoplasm in a set of 10 steps. The reaction of glycolysis can be divided into two phases. One, energy investment phase, that is made up of the first 5 reactions, requires 2 ATP molecules and yields 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. The second phase is known as energy generation phase, and in this phase, there is a production of 2 NADH and 4 ATP molecules as byproducts, and a final product of 2 pyruvate molecules. Notice that the first phase uses 2 ATP molecules and the second phase produces 4. Hence, glycolysis produces a net of 2 ATP molecules. Out of the 10 reactions, we'll focus on the 3 regulated. These reactions are irreversible and serve as controlling points for glycolysis. The first regulated reaction is the first step of glycolysis, which is the phosphorylation of glucose into glucose 6-phosphate. This is done to trap glucose molecules inside the cells, as phosphorylated glucose molecules cannot easily pass the lipid core of the cell membrane. In order for this reaction to happen, we will need 1 ATP molecule. This reaction is carried out by one of two enzymes. The first one, hexokinase, which is found in most cells, is inhibited by its product glucose 6-phosphate, while the second enzyme, glucokinase, which is found in the liver cells and pancreatic beta cells, isn't inhibited by the product. Next, glucose 6-phosphate is converted into fructose 6-phosphate in a reaction catalyzed by the enzyme phosphoglucose isomerase. After that comes the second regulated reaction, which is the third step. In this reaction, fructose 6-phosphate is phosphorylated into fructose 1,6-bisphosphate by the enzyme phosphofructokinase 1. This is the most important controlling point in glycolysis because it can be regulated by 4 different molecules. It is activated by high levels of AMP, which is an indicator of decreased energy levels in the cells. It is also activated by a molecule called fructose 2,6-bisphosphate, which is similar to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate with a difference in one of the the phosphate group's location. This molecule is the most potent regulator of phosphofructokinase 1, and it's made by a reaction catalyzed by an enzyme called phosphofructokinase 2. Phosphofructokinase 1 can be inhibited in two ways. The first is when the levels of ATP are increased, which is an indicator of increased energy levels in the cells. The second is by increased concentration of citrate, which is a product of the second stage of cellular respiration, which also indicates high energy levels, as we are going to see in future videos. The fourth step is catalyzed by the enzyme fructose bisphosphate aldolase, which cleaves fructose 1,6-bisphosphate into dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate. These two products are interconverted, and in order to continue in the glycolytic pathway, dihydroxyacetone phosphate must be converted into glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate, which means we'll have two molecules of glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate. Thus, keep in mind that every reaction after this step will occur twice. The next step involves the oxidation of glyceraldehyde-3 phosphate and reduction of NAD positive into NADH, producing two NADH molecules and two molecules of 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Each 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate molecule is then dephosphorylated, yielding an ATP molecule and a 3-phosphoglycerate molecule. Afterwards, each molecule of 3-phosphoglycerate will be converted into a 2-phosphoglycerate molecule by changing the position of the phosphate group. Next, we'll make a phosphoenol pyruvate, an energy-rich molecule, by a removal of a water molecule. Finally, phosphoenol pyruvate will undergo dephosphorylation, donating its phosphate group to a molecule of ADP, producing a molecule of ATP. After the removal of the phosphate group, phosphoenol pyruvate will be converted into pyruvate. This reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme pyruvate kinase. This reaction is the third regulated step of glycolysis. It is activated by fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, a mechanism called feed-forward activation, and inhibited by increased levels of ATP. Now that we know the three control points of glycolysis, let's take a look at their hormonal regulation. All of the three steps are activated by insulin, a hormone that indicates a well-fed state, and inhibited by glucagon, a hormone that indicates a fasting state. At the end of glycolysis, pyruvate has three fates. 1. In the presence of oxygen and mitochondria, pyruvate is oxidatively decarboxylated, which means it has lost a carbon molecule in an oxidoreduction reaction. This reaction is catalyzed by three enzymes known collectively as pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, yielding acetyl-CoA as a final product. Acetyl-CoA is the major fuel of Krebs cycle, as we'll see in a future video. 2. In the absence of oxygen, like skeletal muscle cells during strenuous exercise, or in the absence of mitochondria, like red blood cells, pyruvate is converted into lactate in a reaction catalyzed by the enzyme lactate dehydrogenase. This reaction is important in order for glycolysis to happen because it requires NAD positive. This reaction supplies the cells with NAD positive as a byproduct and lactic acid as a final product. 3. In yeast and some bacteria, pyruvate is converted into ethanol in an alcohol fermentation reaction. This is an anaerobic reaction and produces carbon dioxide as a byproduct. So, in this video we talked about glycolysis, the first stage of cellular respiration, we discussed the different transport systems by which glucose enters the cell, we saw the reactions that glycolysis consists of and how they are regulated, and finally, the fates of pyruvate at the end of glycolysis. Thank you for watching, we hope it helped you understand glycolysis better. Make sure to subscribe to our channel, like this video, and leave a feedback or question in the comments section below.